you know, growing up, I had a lot given to me and stuff. You know, I lived with my father who was pretty wealthy. He made, you know, some good money with the business that he ran. What happened was my dad wasn't good at managing his money, and he was also a gambler, and I didn't notice this. So, because, you know, being young, and basically what happened was my dad lost everything. He kind of hit a midlife crisis, and yeah, that's pretty much how I started being homeless. I haven't been on the street as in sleeping on the street. I've stayed at friends' houses, but I haven't had my own house and base or apartment. And what the problem is just things are expensive out here. And a lot of these people that live out here have an income from a family member, or they get help from their family. And so I didn't have family members or things like that to help me, so I was on my own. Well, right now we're at Albert Park, and this is a place where you could kind of just hang out, and especially after you get some food from the Chow Hall, which is down the street more. So you go to the Chow Hall and you get your food, and then you come over here and you kind of just hang out. It's a nice park, and this is where I spent some time just kind of thinking and trying to get my head together about what I want to do. As an adult, I'm 21 now, I kind of didn't get in trouble until, you know, I was kind of staying on the streets, not sleeping on the streets, but I didn't have a, you know, homeless, staying friends of friends' houses. And I was drinking with some people, and they had turned on me, and I, you know, used some pepper spray. Cops got into it. It was kind of messy. That's going to be the problem, is having those misdemeanors on my record, because now job applications, they do ask if you have been convicted of anything. I work at Conservation Corps in Nevada. It's cool, it's really far out of the way. I'm only able to work 1 hour a week because I go to school Monday through Thursday. It's just not being able to get enough hours. Managing my money, that's the hardest. I spend my money a lot fast. You know, not on like things I don't need, on things I need, but, well, I would say, you know, like eating out a lot, because I didn't have a place to put groceries or things like that, so I tend to eat out. The way I get by is from financial aid from school, College of Marin. And basically, you go full time, you could get grants. I'm smart. I know all the grants I could get. I also take out loan school money too, because I'm serious about what I want to do. And so that is the main source of income. And it's going to end too. Like, that's the problem, is I've got to find a way for when the financial aid isn't there, how to stay afloat, because I also rent out a room. And so that's going to be the problem. Well, I'm trying to do the nursing program. I'm trying to get into the nursing program, which you got to do a lot of prereq. And so biology is one of those prereqs. And so being this is my first period, my first class, I have it in the first folder or the first divider. And, you know, I got my, you know, some notes, and then I got my biology observation questions, because we have a museum where we got to answer questions. I see my future going good. I've never been more on top of things than now. Main problem was I never really did drugs, but I smoked weed, and that kind of just made me lazy. And a lot of people do that out here, but a lot of people also have everything given to them, so they kind of have the room to kind of slack off. I don't have the room to slack off or be lazy or nothing like that. So once I quit smoking weed, after I got out of jail, I just, you know, became more faster, quicker thinker, ready to get things done. And so I think I'm going to get everything I want to get, which is I want to get my job in nursing. I want to get a certificate in solar power installation. I want to have a steady income and be able not to worry about paying rent. And so I see everything going good.